Good morning, students. Today I will teach you teaching learning process. In subheadings are concepts of teaching and learning, definition, theories of teaching and learning, relationship between teaching and learning. Concepts. Teaching is an essential part of education. Its special function is impart knowledge, develop understanding and skills. Then definition. Teaching is a form of interpersonal influence aimed at changing the behavior potential of another person. According to Burton, teaching is the stimulation, guidance, direction and encouragement of learning. According to Smith, teaching is a system of actions involving teaching is a system of action, teaching is a goal-directed action, teaching takes place in situation comprising the controllable and uncontrollable set factors. Operational definitions of teaching. Teaching is imparting knowledge or skill. You can learn more in books and all. If any doubt, you can ask me. Then definitions of teaching. Teaching is a form of interpersonal influence aim at changing the behavior potential of another person. According to John, teaching is an arrangement and manipulation of situations in which there are gaps and obstructions which an individual will seek to overcome and from which he will learn in the course of doing it. Nature and characteristics of teaching. Write down now. Number one, teaching is giving information. Number two, teaching is causing to learn. Number three, teaching is a matter of helping the child to respond to his environment in an effective manner. Number four, teaching is helping to a child to adjust himself to his environment. Next one, teaching is stimulation and encouragement. Next one, teaching is guidance. Next, teaching is training the emotions of child. Next, teaching is both a conscious and unconscious process. Next, teaching is a means of preparation. Next, teaching is formal as well as informal. Next, teaching is an art. Then, teaching as a skilled occupation. Then teaching as a relationship. Last one, teaching is both an art and science. Okay. Then functions of teaching. Creating learning situations. Number two, motivating the child to learn. Then arranging for conditions which assist in the growth of child mind and body. Next, utilizing the initiative and play urges of the children to facilitate learning. Then, turning the children into creative beings. Next, giving information and explaining it. Then, diagnosing learning problems. Then, making curricular material. Then, evaluating, recording and reporting. Then you can learn from book many more. Okay. Then what are the qualities of a good teaching? Write down now. Number one, good teaching recognizes individual differences. Number two, good teaching is causing to learn. Then good teaching previous opportunities for activity. Then good teaching involves skill in guiding learning. Good teaching is kindly and sympathetically. Then good teaching reduces the distance between the teacher and the student. then good teaching is not tied to any method. Then good teaching is cooperative. Good teaching involving careful planning. Then good teaching is democratic. Then good teaching provides desirable and selective information. Then good teaching helps the child to adjust himself to his environment. Good teaching is progressive. Good teaching is both diagnostic and remedial. Then relationship between teaching and learning. Underline it. Teaching is what teachers do. Number two, learning is what students do. Then does a relationship between good teaching and student learning exist? To a degree, but how are they related to a extent is unclear. Then qualities of a good teacher. See the qualities of a good teacher. See, number one, knowledge of subject matter. Number two, patience. Number three, intellectual curiosity. Number four, confidence. Number five, compassion, means sahanubhuti. Number six, achievement. Number seven, planning. Number eight, awareness. Number nine, mentorship. Next, maturity. Next, community involvement. Next, organization. Next, vision. Next, contest. Next, mission. Last one, enthusiasm, means utsav. Okay. Next, we will learn about principles of teaching. Number one, teaching should have clearly defined goals and objectives. Number two, teaching strategies should to the aptitude, interest, and abilities of a students, as teaching is student-centered. Next, teaching to be effective must to the individual difference of students or learners. Pupils learn more effectively when they learn at their own place. Next, teaching is always in social content. It can never be programmed in a vacuum. Next, teaching should correlate with the various ideas and events. Means correlation of the present events can be made with the past. Next, teaching should emphasize the students' active participation. In all the stages and steps of teaching learning, active learning with much participation of learners as possible is more rewarding and lasting. Then teacher-student cooperation is essential in teaching and learning. Next, in teaching, some remedial or compensatory or extra teaching for some students who have some difficulties in learning. Then, in teaching, there should be proper physical and social environment in the classroom for motivating learners. Next one, planning in teaching is very essential, which involves preparation of the lesson notes, provision of teaching aids, and working out strategies to deliver lessons properly. Teaching process to be effective must adopt proper means and strategies and tact. Then a teacher must be quite imaginative and resourceful for adapting himself and his teaching to the requirements of teaching learning environments. A variety of teaching aids and strategies should be adopted to motivate and sustain interest of students. Teacher should keep the class active and all around development of personality of students. In addition to specific learning by individuals, one acquires qualities of stability and introvertedness. Teacher should adopt the principles of play way is related to learning by doing. Gives joy, freedom, contentment, and inner and outer peace. The learner learns things by doing. Teacher should do his best to motivate all the students in the lesson, which arouses interest, leads to willing to concentrate and work. Motivated learner is more likely to learn than unmotivated learner. Teaching must be enabled the student to work independently and without the teacher at later stages. They can self-educate. Good learning habits are very fruitful. Teaching is the stimulation, guidance, direction, and encouragement of learning. Next, there are different things or ideas which come across in teaching. They should go together and should be associated with each other. There should be provision for change, rest, and recreation to avoid reduce fatigue, lack of attention, and all. There should be proper feedback and reinforcement. Teaching should train the senses of students, means power of observation, discrimination, identification, generalization, and application. There should be suitable climate for group dynamics, or is to be created in the classroom environment. There should be an opportunity provided for the students to explore things and events and find cause-effect relationships. Practice in a variety of settings increase the range of situation in which learning can be applied. Whether it is better to learn from part to whole or from whole to part, and whether all learning takes place in small steps, progressively made, or in larger chunks and open matters. Types of teaching theories. What are the theories are used in teaching and learning? Formal theory of teaching. Number one, Mutic theory. Number two, communication theory of teaching. Number three, molding theory of teaching. Number four, the mutual inquiry theory. Number two, descriptive theory of teaching. Theories of instruction, prescriptive theory of teaching. Third one, normative theory of teaching. Cognitive theory of theory of teacher, psychological theory of teaching, general theory of teaching. Okay. Now I will discuss maxims of teaching. Okay. Maxims of teaching are accepted truth or general rule of conduct or the laws which are essentially to be followed by a teacher while teaching. Okay. Number one, proceed from known to unknown. Number two, proceed from concrete to abstract. Number three, proceed from simple to complex. Number four, proceed from easy to more difficult. Next, proceed inductively. Next, proceed from general to specific. Then, proceed from specific to general. Then, proceed from indefinite to definite. Next, proceed from empirical to rational. Next, proceed from whole parts. Then, proceed from part to whole. Next, proceed from analysis to synthesis. Next, proceed from overview to details. Next, proceed from observation to reasoning. And last one is, proceed from psychological to logic. Okay.